Hello, in this video, we shall review the usage tracking configuration in the Oracle Analytics Semantic Modeler. We will also discuss the key configuration options and best practices to optimize the usage tracking functionality in Oracle Analytics for performance and insights. Before diving into the configuration, here is a checklist of prerequisites that should be met. We will be using Oracle Autonomous Database for implementation in this video. Start by creating a usage tracking schema in the database and assigning the necessary grants. Then go to Oracle Analytics and create a new connection in the Data Connections page. Choose the database type Oracle Autonomous Database in this case and provide the required details. Checking the System Connection checkbox will make this connection available for use in the Semantic Modeler. This approach with the Oracle Analytics data connection streamlines maintenance and supports seamless migration of the semantic model and reports across different environments. Now let's proceed to add the usage tracking connection to the semantic model. Navigate to Semantic Models and create a database object for the usage tracking database. In the physical layer, select Create Database and enter an appropriate name. In the Connection Pools tab, input the connection pool name and select the usage tracking connection from the available list. Make sure that the Require Fully Qualified Table Names checkbox is unchecked. Once done, validate and save the work. Next, go to Oracle Analytics Application, Console, System Settings, Usage Tracking. Enter the usage tracking connection pool and table names. Applying the changes will create the mentioned tables in the schema. Here is a snippet of some of the available usage tracking tables and columns. To validate the configuration, execute some reports in Oracle Analytics and confirm that the usage tracking data is being populated by querying the specified usage tracking tables, either using a SQL client tool or creating an analysis using the direct database request feature in classic analysis of Oracle Analytics. Let's now look at the two main challenges that could occur when validating the configuration. If the usage tracking tables are not created in the usage tracking schema, review the settings entered in the Oracle Analytics console system settings. Verify that each setting is correctly formatted in the specified syntax and without any leading or trailing spaces. In this example, we notice a leading space and a trailing space in the settings. After correcting this value and applying the changes, the tables are successfully created. Another common challenge is when the configuration is successful and tables are created, but no data populates or data stops updating within an existing setup. In such cases, first, ensure that the usage tracking data connection is valid by inspecting and testing it. Re-upload the wallet in the connection if needed. Further, validate the semantic model connection pool by confirming that the schema and tables list correctly. Additional points to consider include checking the usage tracking max source parameter. If a specific limit is set, the usage tracking tables will delete older records as the limit is reached to allow for new entries. Also, note that the usage tracking init block table includes information only on session initialization blocks and not the repository initialization blocks. Let's now look at an example report on the usage tracking data. This sample usage tracking workbook shows information on the application usage, such as report query, user session, and execution time. Likewise, further analysis can be performed on the usage tracking data with the available reporting and visualization capabilities. Do check out the sample usage tracking project provided in the description below. This covers the topic on how to enable the usage tracking in Oracle Analytics Semantic Model and gain insights for efficient monitoring on application usage. Thanks for watching this video.